So the last couple of days, I've just been feeling nothing, like wiped right out. So, gotta take some precaution, and I'm gonna do a vitamin B12 injection. Used to do these all the time when I ran. I had a problem getting proper, adequate B12. So, I remember back in 2000, I did the Ottawa Marathon, and just before the race, I was just feeling like couldn't maintain anything, couldn't do anything. So, I got a B12 shot, and it really helped. So, I'm hoping this takes me out of my funk here. Got a rest week coming up, but I still got 3 days left. Hopefully this does the trick. Usually it does. Clean the area. Section. Do it just in the arm, up the arm, towards the end. Decision wise, they're going no problem. Hopefully that'll get me out of my funk. So just did 112, one millimeter of B12. You can get this at any pharmacy. And I'm using an insulin needle. Easy, just done. So we got 3 hours on the bike today. Usually it takes a couple hours for the thing to hit. So hopefully I ride later on and it'll hit soon. Bit of an issue here. We got some trees down over here. Got a ride to do on Zwift, but power's out everywhere. Luckily, I got the generator going. got the generator going, tapped into the house, which runs this side of the house, which is fortunately where my pain cave is. So let's see if we got Wi-Fi, and let's see if we're going to be able to get this riding. The challenges of training when the power goes out in Hamilton, Ontario. Looks like the internet's down. Probably gonna have to tether in through the phone. It's probably the only alternative we can do here. So that's what we're gonna have to try to do. See if we can tether in through the phone. Coming up to the end of the first hour, 60 minutes, averaging around 215. X25 is in the big plate, 25 minutes, 60 to 65 RPM. Should suck bad. About a 60k ride. There's the workout. And another one nailed. Finish up the climb, eh? There it is. Boom, 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 boom. Look at the TSS, 117, that's a nice TSS. 231 average. Almost 10 o'clock on a Friday, and you know what that is, right? These things are well earned.
So, just 2 hours outdoors. It's starting to rain. I'm cold. The roads are like shit. People are driving like retards. I'm just gonna finish it off on Swift. Heading into the house. Pretty mild average, small ring action, 95 RPM average. Today's more endurance miles. Tomorrow is big ring, last hard ride of really phase one. We're heading to Bristol Mountain next week for the first gallop. It's like a sea gallop. It's not my goal race, just to see where I'm at. That's what we're gonna do. Rochester, New York, Bristol Mountain. Should be all right. GoPro, stop recording. GoPro, stop recording. So a lot of fancy videos, talking and stuff, ride footage, and everybody's probably wondering, well, what's the system, Shane? Like, is what you're doing working? Well, I'm going to show you exactly how it's been impacting me, The session that really has been on the bike power, force development, it's building power on the bike, building strength on the bike. The first force development session that David had me do was back a couple weeks ago. It was, what's the date here? Let me get the date off of Strava here. Let's see if we get the date here. It was on April the 22nd on a Sunday. I did the Forest Development ride. Now, he had me do a little bit before and a little bit after, but the main section was this 20-minute section. So for 20 minutes, I put it into a big gear, a gear that was, well, what I averaged, what did I average? We can see right here. My average cadence was, I'd have to go to the analysis part, and we can see this very easily. We'll go down here. So here's the section here. This is the forest development section right here. It's about 20 minutes, yeah, a little bit over. So the average cadence was 62 RPM. But you see on the laps, I averaged 270 watts. All right, boom. Same workout, we do it again the week after. Did a little bit more prior, a little bit more after. But in the middle, I did a 25-minute segment. Again, very low cadence, 281 watts. So what was the heart rate on that? I averaged 132, 281. That's an 11 watt. The heart rate was a little bit higher, a little bit higher, a little bit higher. But still, I'm putting out more power on the bike. This actually felt harder than this, but the heart rate was slightly higher. Then you come to this week, and look what I did. I did 295, 133. What was it last week? 132, 281. 295, 25-minute segment, 133. Just pleasantly surprised at the power. If you do the math, that's 25 watts in the exact same session. 25 watts I put on in the exact same session. People say, oh, your heart rate's a little bit higher. Well, my max heart rate's gone up. I haven't seen it over 150 in years. And then with David, you know, I'm venturing into the high 150s because I'm tapping into a different energy system. Instead of trying to force the gear, I'm spinning the gear a lot more, and it's a more cardiovascular based energy source instead of muscular, right? So that's why you see more response in terms of the heart rate. But even at low cadences, at the high cadences, I can get my heart rate high fast now. It was always a problem in the past. But yeah, I'll take 25 watts. I mean, that's proofs in the pudding. Yeah, I mean, people lie, but data doesn't. So that's a good from this 270 to this in the exact same session with more time on the bike here, because the first one was a 20-minute interval, to this, that's beautiful. That's beautiful. See you guys next week's the big race. First, it's a C race, but it's the first one of the campaign. Loving it. Loving it. Peace out.